in Ulysses, Part 1, Episode 1, The Telemachiad, Telemachus. It's 8 o'clock a.m. on Thursday, June 16th, 1904, on the outskirts of Dublin. Buck Mulligan and Stephen Dedalus talk on the rooftop of a Martello Tower, a coastal fort no longer in use for defense. They live there, together with a third roommate, an Englishman named Haynes. Stephen's thoughts drift to memories of his mother, who died a year before following a difficult illness. He recalls seeing his dead mother in a dream. It's revealed that Buck's aunt thinks Stephen killed his mother, perhaps by going to Paris, perhaps because at her deathbed, Stephen refused to kneel and pray with her. Stephen compares Buck's cracked shaving mirror to a symbol of Irish art. Buck makes breakfast for himself, Stephen, and Haynes as an old Irish woman drops by to deliver their milk. Haynes, the Englishman, speaks Gaelic to her, but she doesn't understand him. Discussing history, politics, and religion, Buck, Stephen, and Haynes walk to the shore to swim in the sea. Buck borrows some money from Stephen. Haynes calls himself a Britisher and says he does not want his country to be overrun by German Jews. The novel does not capitalize the word Jew. Buck asks Stephen to give him the key to the tower, and Stephen feels put out by Buck and Haynes, then leaves to teach a class at a boys' school. The first three episodes are called the Telemachiad, a Greek word that means the story of Telemachus. These episodes focus on Stephen Dedalus, who plays a role akin to that of Odysseus' son Telemachus in Homer's Odyssey. Sometimes the narration is omniscient, and sometimes it's a stream of consciousness, a style of narration that gets very close to a character's thoughts and inner sense expressions. The style of giving only fragments of Stephen's thoughts leads intrigue to his character. His thoughts are alluded to without being fully explained. When Stephen asks Buck about the day Stephen visited him after his mother's death, Buck claims, "I can't remember anything. I remember only ideas and sensations." Joyce may be drawing on the ideas of 18th century English philosopher David Hartley, who claimed that memory does not contain records of events, only ideas and sensations. Stephen feels oppressed and constrained by his living situation, and Joyce uses that to mirror Ireland's situation. And consider the cracked mirror itself. Art reflects life like a mirror, and Irish art, the art of a nation subservient to England, distorts reality.